on to the latest coming in. Sources telling WION that Pakistan will remain on the Financial Action Task Force's grey list. The decision was made by the Paris-based terror financing watchdog. Pakistan has yet again failed to trick the world into believing that it has been curbing terror. Pakistan recently, remember, convicted 2611 mastermind Hafiz Saeed in two terror financing cases. However, as WION reported, Saeed was given VVIP treatment. In fact, at the court, he was escorted in a bulletproof vehicle and provided better security that was given to high-profile political prisoners, including former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif. That was a clear message once again. And Pakistan has now been put or has now, will now remain on the FATF's grey list. Let's get in further details now from our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Sibyl. Pakistan, Siddhant, has been desperately trying to get out off the grey list, has been making several attempts in that direction. But the fact of the matter is that since it has failed to clamp down on terror financing on its soil, even Hafiz Saeed's conviction was a mere eyewash. The FATF, of course, is not convinced with these acts.
Well, there's good news and then, of course, there's the bad news. Let me start with the bad news. Pakistan won't be on the blacklist, something that a lot of countries in the world, including India, have been wanting to. But the good news is it remains on grey list, and that, of course, harms the Pakistani economy. Well, the FATF sources in FATF, the country sources, have been saying that they would like to see Pakistan act more, do more when it comes to the issue of terrorism. Of course, there have been certain developments, including when it comes to Hafiz Saeed. But largely, it has been considered as a hogwash. It has been considered something that Pakistan has been doing just before any FATF meeting. Remember, in the last meeting which happened in the month of October, we saw the FATF president, the new FATF president, who comes, of course, from China, had clearly given a warning to Pakistan that it needs to do more, it needs to act more. And since then, there have been some several minor meetings as well, whether it's in Canberra or whether it's in Beijing, these smaller group meetings, the Asia-Pacific group meetings, which has been taking place. And by and large, they have been asking Pakistan to do more. But, of course, we know that blacklist is something that many countries would like to see on. The meeting is about to begin in few hours' time in Paris. And before that, you know, a release was issued by the FATF in which it confirmed that progress made by Pakistan and other countries that present a risk to the financial system will be on the agenda. So clearly, we'll get to know what is the final decision only on 21st of this month through a press release and, of course, a press conference. But by and large, it's now confirmed that Pakistan will remain on the grey list.
Right. And if you can also, Siddhant, talk about what this means for the Pakistani economy, because the very fact that Pakistan is on the grey list has been hurting its crumbling economy. And statements made by the country's own finance minister indicating that this will mean that the economy will further be squeezed and the crisis will further mount for Pakistan.
Well, Pakistani foreign minister himself has considered that it's causing a huge damage to the Pakistani economy. When a country is put on a grey list of FATF, that means that the jurisdiction, if an investor invests in the country, his money can be used for financing of terrorism, and that no investor in the world, any sane investor across the world, would not like to see. That is why there are no investors coming, and if Pakistan is put on the blacklist, which of course it's not being put as of now, it will be more serious consequences. We can see more serious consequences for the Pakistani economy. In fact, the bailout terms also were, in a sense, linked to Pakistan doing more under the FATF commitments it had made. It's almost been more than 1 year for Pakistan on the grey list, and that means huge losses for the Pakistani economy, which is already facing a lot of brunt when it comes to its own internal issues. It has recently got a bailout from global multilateral organizations, and we do expect Pakistan to give one of its plea in front of the FATF when the meeting starts. That it's high time that it's removed from the FATF because it's impacting its economy and thus its people.
Right. And before we let you go, Siddhan, just a quick check also on the very fact that the number of commitments that Pakistan was asked to adhere by, it had failed on most of those counts. If you can just elaborate for our viewers what the findings of the FATF exactly have been.
Before this formal plenary, which is about to begin in Paris, there was two smaller meetings which happened in Canberra and Beijing. Beijing was the latest meeting which took place in the month of January 2020. And in these meetings, the APG meetings, the Asia-Pacific group of the FATF meeting, it was put on record the Pakistani commitments which Pakistan has been making. And of course, the Pakistani delegates were quizzed on whether they have fulfilled its commitments or not. While there are a few backers for Pakistan in the FATF, including Turkey and Malaysia, there are most of the countries, most of the Western countries, whether it's US, whether it's France, and of course India, have been quizzing the Pakistani delegates of just mere hogwash, which it has been indulging in. But these commitments will finally be placed in front of the FATF plenary, and only then we'll get to know that what happens, what is the final decision which is being taken. But it seems that no blacklisting as of now. And we know that just before this meeting was to begin, we saw the Turkish president was in Pakistan. He publicly stated that we will be backing Pakistan when it comes to FATF. And FATF is a consensus-driven organization. That means that everyone has to have a consensus to take a formal decision. So if there is no consensus, even if one country, which of course includes Turkey, says that we should give more time to Pakistan, then of course Pakistan has a face saver to show, especially to domestic audience.
Absolutely. We're going to leave it there for the moment, Siddhan. Thanks very much for those updates. Pakistan will remain on the FATF's grey list. Remember, Pakistan's efforts when it comes to trying to show the world that it has been doing enough when it comes to clamping down on terror, certainly not convincing the FATF. The Global Anti-Terror Financing Watchdog has decided that the country will remain on the country's grey list. No blacklisting for now for Pakistan, but far-reaching implications continuing for its economy, since it will now stay on the FATF grey list.